Monday, June 27th, it is 6:33 p.m. I believe Gail is recording, Gail McSweeney, on her own personal device.
I will be, thank you.
You're welcome. Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through an audio recording, which will be used to ensure an accurate record of proceedings produced in the minutes of the meeting. All comments made in this open session will be recorded. Okay. We're reviewing payroll and the minutes of the meeting, and when someone is done, can I get a motion to accept the minutes of the meeting as written? No, the previous week. They're in that one. They're the ones from when council was here.
Mm-hmm. And that was when Gail was the person.
Correct.
All right, gotcha. Who was the name?
June 6th.
I'd like to make a motion to accept the minutes as written from June 6, 2016's Board of Health meeting.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
And Gail, I'm assuming you're abstaining because you weren't here.
Yes.
Okay.
Donna, is this chairman's statement with notice against multiple copies? Is this for us?
No, that's just in the, that just stays in the, but if you would like a copy.
Okay.
I don't see why you don't. It's just, there's lots of copies in there just in case it gets misplaced. And I pull it out and read from it every meeting and every other department has one. Can I have the one with this sticky in that one? Yeah. Yeah, that stuff is nothing. It's only the payroll and the minutes of the meeting.
Talking to me?
Yes.
This is all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's just all
just
excess paperwork.
Okay.
Correct.
What's that?
Yeah.
Oh, that's you.
This is me.
Oh, where's...
No.
Was this in a folder?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. This folder?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and there's the minutes.
Which we just approved.
But, no.
I'm sorry.
Time out. Time out!
That's our Board of Health folder.
This is our Board of Health folder.
Right.
Yeah, so what you have signed... So did you sign payroll?
Yes, I did.
Wonderful.
Did Gail.
Okay, perfect. All done. Okay. Correspondence. There was a question about validity about comments made in the minutes of the meeting from the one where town council came in regards to the complaints. It was stated that it was a hypothetical situation. We were instructed to have the minutes of those meeting stated verbatim. So that's why the minutes of the meeting look like the way that they do. Okay? Even though it was hypothetical, it still gives us how we got there and where we ended up getting to. Board of Health, we do have a drafted letter about Ben Bassanelli, and he actually is going to be coming July
27th
to that meeting. I said 7:15-ish. I'm sorry? July 25th. Yeah, not June. July 25th, so he's already confirmed by email that he will be here. Carol, I'm just going to sign this letter and put it in the purple folder. Okay.
Get him slated 7:15.
Get him 7:15, but we did tell him to come a little bit earlier just in case the agenda is not as packed, and we can have him in and out of here.
Donna, did you have in your file there the reply for the Monday, June 22nd for Sabrina for the Board of Health that we discussed?
Oh, yeah. The one that I forwarded over to her?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep, that's kind of, we're just going to talk about that.
Oh, okay, I want to give this to Gary and this to you. And one more thing before we talk about that, can the board explain to me why we have Ms. Princeton out at every board meeting since I have come on to this board?
Well, it is my understanding that it has been requested.
From what grounds and why?
Lisa, would you like to?
I have no problems.
Okay.
From the selectman's office, from what I received, the action was taken by the secretary, by the health agent, and by the administrator.
Mm-hmm.
So you have no knowledge on why?
I have knowledge. As I explained in the email that you sent to me, I felt it's something that you should ask directly of the health agent, of the secretary.
Yeah, but in lieu of the first correspondence that was read on the first meeting, that would be crossing over, it would be a violation.
No, reread that letter, because that letter does not tell you that you cannot speak to the secretary. What that letter states is that any correspondence is to be an email form on the town email address.
It states not to be contacted in case of unless it's an emergency. Other than that, I am to contact you.
Can I get a copy of that, just so that we can read that, the first sentence of that letter, Carol? I really didn't think that this was the format or the platform for us to bring it up, but it has come to my attention, as well as several others, that due to historical situations that took place when neither I nor Mr. Fine had anything to do with the Board of Health, that there are still issues that are unresolved, and if an employee does not feel comfortable, it is within their right to go to the town administrator and ask for police presence.
I haven't been with the board for over 6 years. I have not worked in this office for over 6 years.
I know you
years.
Haven't.
So I don't understand what warrants that claim, and I'm going to ask the board to give me, in the future, to provide me with some more clarity on that.
Well, I'm going to instruct you, if you need clarity, I want you to please speak directly to Mr. Thorne.
Mr. Thorne has no control over the Board of Health. And if you will read this here, this text from Sabrina's office, of June 22nd, 2009, that the Board of Health made a vote, and it specifically says that Mr. McGinnis was the one that initiated that. Now, if you go to the next page, you will have an agenda, and you will have the Board of Health meeting minutes for June 22nd, and nowhere on here was there a vote for the Board of Health to relinquish any responsibilities to the Board of Selectmen.
I'm reading this for the first time, and as our chair alluded to.
Well, we were all emailed this on the 21st.
But I'm reading it for the first time.
Okay.
So, as our chair alluded, there were some events that took place prior to Donna and I being on the board.
Correct.
So, if I were using maybe common sense as opposed to some protocol, when I see this, and I see Town Administrator Ed Thorne oversee day-to-day operations of the board, I would suggest you obviously have a concern. You raised an inquiry.
The Board of Health is autonomous.
Okay. Ed Thorne, I don't want to... I didn't have to speak on this. This is to 2009.
And please let him speak. Yeah, don't interrupt.
Just as a courtesy, I would, if I had the same query that you did, I would probably make that query to Ed. And that would just be me. And I'd make an informal inquiry if it's something that concerns
you.
We
are doing this backwards. The Board of Health is autonomous. I would not inquire from anyone else outside of this office. This office is under Chapter 41, Section 21 of the Mass General Laws. The only way that we can relinquish any duties or any powers from the Board of Health office is at a town meeting through 2/3 vote. It cannot be done by the staff, by the board members. We don't have that authority. The Mass General Law trumps that, to tell us that that is a vote to be done by the people.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to repeat myself again. The situation that went down, how involved it was, or how whatever situation took place, because I was not a privy to it, it rocked this department to its knees. So if there are any ill feelings, any uncomfortable situations that still exist due to those 3 or 4 years, however long it was, has nothing to do with this existing sitting board. If you want to explore, and I'm telling you, Gail, I've said it and I've said it on camera, I am not going back there. If an employee addresses Ed Thorne, that has nothing to do with us. She's a paid employee. If she does not feel safe, feels intimidated, or just feels crummy about it, she has the legal right as an employee under a union, thank you, under a union, then she is within her union rights to go to Mr. Thorne and request an officer. I'm not going to override her. I can take a vote right now.
You're missing the point here, that the Board of Selectmen and Mr. Thorne have no authority over the Board of Health. Maybe in the union district, but that should be with her shop steward. But what I did notice on the meeting of June 6th is that council was here, correct me if I'm wrong, was here to address the board's violations.
Correct.
Right. There was quite a dialogue with the health agents.
She was a complainant.
The board, the attorney, council was sent here to address the board, us. Doesn't make any difference. She was here to represent the board.
Mm-hmm. Council was here. Are you referring to the meeting that you weren't here?
Correct.
So council was here to offer a legal opinion as to respond to the two complaints that were made,
which you and Ms. Dagny addressed. That had nothing to do with the health agent. As far as...
Wait, what? It seemed like we're talking about two different issues.
Well, if I don't know about you, but when you represent council, do they represent both parties?
I'm not an attorney.
Do they represent both parties?
They can.
They represent the town. They represent the town of Pembroke. You and I, as elected bodies, fall under the town of Pembroke. We are elected officials. The other two positions in this office are hourly rate paid. One is a paid employee, one is under a union. Okay? The office duties, the office and the staff report to Ed Thorne. You have a question on why it's been requested, then you need to go to their boss.
That would be the same as me attending the Board of Selectmen's meeting to ask me for my resignation. The Board of Selectmen have no authority and no power over me. Therefore, there was no reason for the executive session.
Again,
Can I clarify something? You understand the Board of Selectmen is offering up, acting in two functions right now. They are also wage and personnel.
I do understand that, and I'm going to tell you right now, I've been in touch with ethics, and unless you want to put this straight and reclaim the Board of Health, it is an ethical situation for the selectman in Ms. Thorne to be involved in the Board of Health.
A Okay, so that...
We're not running the way that we should be. We're running for, we're supposed to be running for the people, and we're letting other offices...
And we haven't even gotten to anything that has to do with the people of Pembroke yet in the last three meetings that we've had?
That has nothing to do with me. I did not call police personnel. I did not decide to read a letter of limitations for the board, for a brand new board member at the first meeting. Donna, where this board needs to run under the law. We are not running under the law right now. We're not running for the people. If we were running for the people, we would have control over our department.
And what control don't we have? I guess the word that you used a lot on the campaign trail, okay, and forgive me, it's been a long day, was you wanted to see change. What is that change? Why do you not feel that the Board of Health is operating, number one, you've just said ethically, and I take great, great offense to you making that statement, because you don't know what you're talking about. Okay?
That's your opinion.
That is my opinion. Ethically, this board has functioned and has worked for the people and only the people of Pembroke. Your issue has nothing to do with this three-seated board and these five variances that we have to get to. So I'm not going to discuss. That police officer is here due to the request of a employee of the town of Pembroke. Okay? Her letter was read. Whether Mr. Fine became chairperson or you became Mr. Chairperson, it was a correspondence that was requested to be read due to past history between you and the secretary. I agreed to abide by it. Nowhere does it say in that letter, and I'll read it again if you want, but I really don't think you want me to. Nowhere in that letter does it state that Carol Murata states that you cannot speak to her, ask her any question. You can ask any question of her. If there's an error on agenda meeting, you can turn around and send her an email. Geez, could you just double check this date and see if there's an issue? No, it does not say that. It says we're not to give out her personal phone number.
Why would that be? First of all, Donna, the way that this was conducted, it wasn't on the meeting minutes that you were reading a retirement letter from the secretary. But then you read a statement that you received 10 minutes before the meeting. I'm not apprised of what's going on as a new board member. Neither was the clerk. Then the next thing I know, after this letter, we're doing open meeting violation. Open violation meetings were caused by that letter because I was told that it would be best for me to contact you and then you would direct the rest of the staff.
Mm-hmm. I would direct anything that you didn't feel getting in contact with Carol directly. But you have every right to contact her at C. Murata.
Also, in that letter, it was stated that I was not to be contacted unless it was an emergency to Ms. Murata.
Okay. We're going to take a bathroom break for a moment, please. We're back on. I pulled out the letter. It is dated May 16, 2016. The first sentence states, in light of the past history in this office with Gail McSweeney, I wish to announce that I will only communicate with her via the town's email and only when absolutely necessary. What that means or what I will imply it to mean is the fact that anything having to do with Board of Health that we deal with as a board. Elections was on May 14th. This letter was drafted May 16th. It was held right after the elections. It was a Monday evening. I don't know, timing-wise, do you think it didn't make it on the agenda because it was 2 days after the election? Mm-hmm. And it was sent through as correspondence to the Board of Health. So it was addressed to the Board of Health.
But it was not in full correspondence. It didn't say statement from secretary retirement or statement from secretary. I mean, it's got to be, you can't just make an open statement. Anybody could put anything in there. In the agenda, it needs to make complete of what the letter is going to be about.
It wasn't an agenda. It wasn't a topic for conversation. It was a correspondence to the board.
That
just
should
like,
have been under correspondence, read by...
The agenda is a blanket statement that says, and review any correspondence.
No.
Gail, that was a... Okay. We're going to agree to disagree, and I'll leave it at this, because when you mentioned about the ethics, and I think you were getting ready to say something else, maybe you weren't, but if you feel that you need to exercise any right that you feel, please feel free to do that. I personally and professionally would like to get on with the business that we have in hand, because we have 5 homeowners that are looking to have their septic system passed.
I understand that, but unless this board is running properly, we're not doing our job the right way.
And I, for the record, for the record again, will you state why you don't feel the board is running the way it should be?
Because we have a letter from the selectman's office stating that Monday, June 22nd, 2009, mm-hmm. that Mr. McGinnis appointed Mr. Thorne in charge of the Board of Health office. This never took place. You also have the agenda for June 22nd, 2009. It is not on there. It is also not in the meeting minutes. It is reflected nowhere. It is signed. So therefore, if it's not in the meeting minutes, how can you ever tell me that this transpired?
You know, Gail, if I'm not going to make a determination here what you're stating is correct or incorrect. But it goes. You're bringing up an issue on a vote that was taken in 2009. It's not on the agenda. I mean, I'm not quite.
Okay.
Wait, can I finish?
Let me
no,
interject.
I would like to finish.
For 1 second.
Because you were the one, Gail, who started and asked about the police presence, and now you're morphing into. If you have a question, and if it's a legitimate question about the police presence, that's fine. But now you're morphing into history that goes back 7 years. You know, you need to go see, I'm almost done.
I haven't spoken.
You need to go see Ed Thorne. Ed Thorne was appointed to run the day-to-day operations of the Board of Health. And if you have a problem with that, that's your right, then go see Ed Thorne. Don't take up 30 minutes of a topic that we weren't prepared to address tonight. I'm not saying your concerns aren't valid. If you have concerns, you should be able to raise them, as does Donna and as does I. But you're bringing up at the start of a meeting something that happened 7 years ago. If you are concerned about the police presence here, then that's your right. Then take it to me, the logical person to ask that question. I would go see Ed Thorne. I don't know why you're saying that the board has not, you know, anyway.
Well, we'll just let the decision come back and see where we're going from there, and hopefully we can straighten out the Board of Health, so the Board of Health is running solely for the Board of Health, for the people.
I feel, for the record, we're running pretty well right now. We can always be running better. I will agree to that. But anyway,
well,
so
once
we're going to move on.
I think we are moving on, but I'm going to end it with the fact that there is a we out there says the Board of Health. On that door, it says the Board of Health. We are an elected board to vote and deal with issues that affect the people of Pembroke. Under the guise of information that the health agent goes out and collects and gathers. So my understanding of the Board of Health, I look at that door, and there's two entities here. There's two entities that make up the Board of Health. With that being said, I've publicly made my statements. You do what you need to, and I would like to move on to our first variance.
Carol, Mr. Field is out there, I believe.
Perfect. So we can see her.
Thank you.
Lisa, do you know if he's the only one that's coming before?
I believe so.
Okay, thank you.
That does not mean that someone cannot show up, of course.
No, I just didn't see it on other...
That has said he is going to.
Thank you.
Mr. Field, how are we today?
Good, how are you?
Fantastic. The board is yours, so you can lay that right over there to Mike. Hopefully they can still hear, but let them see what you've done.
Same that we have.
Good evening.
Good evening.
You're working at 33 Church Street, the show station, Mary Lou, yes. You may remember we were here in May.
Both of you, right? Okay, yep.
I'm John Field, I'm the subject engineer.
John Field, and could you introduce yourself for the media? Great, thank you.
I work for you. So we were here in May to ask for variances from the sideline. What we have is a very large system on a relatively small site. It's an existing site. We have a 100% proposed septic area.
Could we turn this around? Is that okay?
Yeah, it's upside.
Thank you.
Can you do it upside down?
Oh, yeah.
You can read it upside down?
I do.
Okay.
Nope.
Okay. Thank you.
So the road's out here. The street's out here.
139.
Yeah.
Okay.
The street's over here.
Yeah.
I mean,
hopefully. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm good. Thank you. Actually, old
road. Yep. So, my mistake was not catching this 1,800-foot basement area and getting further definition of where the basement extended to. I saw this and said, it's going down the middle of the building like this, so the front half would be basement, the back half would be slab, and my design would fit in there, and I'd have the 10-foot requirement from the edge of the leach facility, or at least the 10-foot to the building line.
Is this... So this half the basement and half the slab, that's the part of the existing, the old structure?
No. The old structure was all slab on brick.
Okay.
I assumed that the line went down the middle, when actually it was perpendicular to the length of the system. So this line here represents a cellar wall. This is full basement over here, and this is slab. So I have an impingement of the 20-foot setback between the leach facility and the building wall. It should be 20 feet, and I have about 14 feet. So I'm looking for variances necessary because I've, again, calculated and carried a full size system without any reductions. However, I don't have enough room to fit the 20-foot setback into here.
All right, so let me just ask a question. And I know you just previously said that. Is this a full basement?
Right here, this line here.
This section is a full basement.
Full basement, yeah.
And this is a slab. And what's the slab's purpose?
Well, it's the walk. Do you have the building plan? Okay, so this is oriented the same way. Septic system back.
Yeah. General store.
Full basement for storage.
Mm-hmm.
And this is slab on grade.
Okay. So the setback is this section because this is just a slab.
Correct.
And what's going on top of the slab? Is this slab going to be used for any purpose?
Yeah, this is part of the store.
It's part of the store.
Part of the whole building.
Part of the inside of the building. Okay.
Had it stayed,
yeah.
You would have had the 20 feet had it been
right.
Sliced that way.
Exactly.
Okay.
My mistake was narrowing that down before I did the design work. This is actually what the building would look like. This is all ground floor. So it's, here's the stairs that go down into the basement.
This, and then the men's and ladies' room are over there.
Over here.
Utility.
Yeah. Over here is it.
Where the drive. Okay.
Yeah. The drive room is up here. And there's their portion of space. And then the superintendent out in the front. So, see, I don't know.
That's okay. So this wasn't a change in the slab side. It was just something you thought.
Yes.
Okay. Now, when you said variances, is there another variance that you're?
Yeah. Also, due to other site constraints, which essentially are that we try to maintain 100% of the area for the system required based on the design flow. I show this 10-foot offset to my tankage, which is Title V compliant. However, this is shown as a 6-foot tank, and the manufacturers don't simply make it a 6-foot tank in the, design or in the gallonage that we need. And I would rather not have to put a train of tanks, two tanks here, because I'd much rather keep the design simple and incorporate the process in one thing rather than having two. So this is actually the original plan that was submitted with that in April or May.
So what's the impact without these variances?
We can make everything work, but when I've mentioned a couple of times the design methodology is to have 100% of the area. Because I'm incorporating an innovative alternative treatment system here, this FAST system, I think I can reduce the system size by 25%. But I would much rather keep the system 100%, get that much better treatment, and be able to stand on the premise that with a greater surface area, we're going to have a system that lasts longer and performs better. That's public health better. The foundation wall is a 1-foot thick wall rather than a typical 8 or 10 inch concrete wall. It's also waterproof and insulated on the outside. The tanks are all H20 loaded tanks. They're impervious. So I don't believe that there's any loss of protection of the public health by reducing the setbacks from 20 to 14 and from 10 to 7.
How much of this is in the ground?
The building is, the foundation is installed, and they've installed the fast tanks, and the leach field has been installed.
Are these fast tanks as well? These are the fast tanks.
Right. Neither one of these have been installed yet. They would rather be able to not. The grease trap is no issue. The 1,000-gallon tanks are readily available at that width. It's the larger tank that they're having an issue with.
Why?
Because it's not made in that width.
So it would be a specific casting if it had to be.
I don't believe that the manufacturer can provide them with the tank. That's my understanding. Discussion between the separate installer and the general contractor.
All right, so it's commercial. It just has restrooms for general public and employees. There's parking for how many? They're making coffee. Are they making the donuts there? They're not making anything there. They're just serving coffee.
What we conclude is 1,000 gallons a day for the food, the islands.
Clean up.
And the where the people are. That combined, people should hold their report. So I, although we're reporting that our actual design flow is much less.
What is the average? You said 45 gallons a day in Henry. What is the average?
I think it's 1650.
Yes.
So it's 1,000 for the pool, I think 200 for the retail, and then there are 5 islands.
But forgive me, the actual flow based on DPW was like, what, half that if memory serves me? Their actual water consumption?
Yeah, by water, their average was...
I think it was about literally half what you've designed for. Yeah. That was their average water usage.
Yeah. All right. Do you have any more questions? The waste is by no means as great, but there are variances asked against this. It's an oversight in the design,
yep.
But yeah, and that's why I wanted to know, what's the cost ramifications if you don't get these variances to the project?
Well, for with cost, I think the first thing would be to reduce the capacity.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a design methodology. I think that if we spread the effluent over a greater area, we have a longer life system.
Mm-hmm.
I could take off, and I think I've thought about it, this chamber here, and then those two, we take off approximately 7 chambers. We can reduce the system by 12%.
You'd prefer the variance.
I would want to show the variance. Mm-hmm. I'm able to say to my client, I've given you the best treatment methodology.
Right. And the town, for that matter.
John, would you indulge me, please, and just go over the second variance once again?
So there's the first one we're talking about is the beach field.
Yep, from the 20 to 14.
The second would be this tank here was shown as 6 feet wide.
Yep.
The installer can't get this thing 6 feet wide. You can get it 9 feet wide, so I have to impinge to this building line by 3 feet. So it'd be 7.
No reserve area proposed. Can you explain that to the board members?
It was an existing site. It had a septic system on it. There's no increase in the design flow, so it's an upgrade.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would like to make a motion, if there are no other further questions, to accept the variances as written for 233 Church Street, aka Shell Gas Station. Do I hear a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
All right.
Don't do it again.
You won't see us again. Until you come by for the grand opening.
You're welcome. Please invite us. We'd love to come.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Good luck. Now you don't have to go back to the drawing board. You're welcome. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
Okay, next up is 41 Lorner Ave.
That's interesting.
Memorial?
Nope.
No.
This is a three-bedroom home on Lorna. It is old. It was abandoned for at least 5 years that I'm aware of. It was purchased by a flipper to be flipped and redone. It's an existing three-bedroom home. However, very nice gentleman that purchased it did not consult with this office or anyone else and realize how poor the soils are on Lorna Avenue, nor how high the water table is. The perk was ridiculously slow, and I think he actually ended up sending it out for SIV, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, he ended up sending it out to SIV, and it came back as very poor material, as we expected it to. Long story short, instead of restoring this as a three-bedroom home, given it is approximately a little under 800 square feet, if memory serves, and he had extreme concerns because the size of the rooms was so small, he has chosen to reduce this home to a two-bedroom home in his new layout. It allows for an open concept living space from basically what would be the kitchen with a laundry closet into what would then be an open sitting slash dining scenario, rather than maintain that third bedroom, and then it would just have two bedrooms at this home. And even with all of that, you can see that's still a pretty substantial system for a two-bedroom home, and even with that, he's asked for the reduction down to 110 gallons a day. So the problem here is you can see the layout. Where do you put this septic? This property is very severely sloped, so the more he brings it around the corner, the more chance of an outbreak. This is where the existing pipe comes out. This is the existing elevation. So he was confronted with a lot of design challenges on this site. So ultimately what he did is reduce the home to a two-bedroom because this is going to be a very expensive septic system to put in. And he needed to use SIV analysis rather than a perk test to determine the classification of soils. And then he wanted a reduction from the flow from our required 150 gallons a day per bedroom down to 110 gallons a day per bedroom. So this is what he's ending up with. He is flipping this home, so of course he had to deal with the septic issue, which was basically a cesspool in very poor soil, therefore it was no longer absorbing.
Where was that, Liz?
Yeah, where was the cesspool?
I want to say it was out right beside one of these sheds. It's somewhere right... You know what? He didn't indicate it. It's somewhere, like, literally, it could even be underneath the shed. One of those sheds is... This shed is leaving. This shed's in horrible condition. It could actually even be under there. There's their tank, though. So it's literally a few feet off the tank in one direction or the other. But there's standing water in it, and that was observed right away by both him and the engineer.
Could this become a three-bedroom home in the future?
Not with a 220-gallon-day flow. It would be absolutely impossible. Never mind that the footprint itself would make it really prohibitive.
It's that 110-gallon day flow, right?
Per bedroom.
Okay.
So it has two bedrooms, so it's 220 in total. Title V accounts for every home. Mr. Field actually did a very good job of alluding it. It has a different design gallon flow depending on your project. In every home, it's always based on bedrooms in Massachusetts. The state requires 110 gallons per day per bedroom. Pembroke's local upgrade regulations require 150 gallons per day per bedroom. At one point, between the 80s and into the early 90s, it was actually 200 gallons a day per bedroom in Pembroke. The board had reduced that either right as I came on or right before I came on. I do not know which. Please don't hold me to that. But sometime right at the point I got involved was when that was changed down to 150. Many towns have some sort of upsizing regulation, whether it be 25% larger or an absolute minimum of three-bedroom design or something like that. Every town's a little different.
The only variance is seeking.
The SIV analysis in that, and the SIV was because the soil was so bad.
Yeah, here's the reported.
That's the SIV. I believe it says.
I don't know if you've ever seen a SIV analysis.
That's actually kind of cool.
Yeah, they take this... particles or whatever, they scoop up and dry
and
it
run
on
it through a series. It's a series of stacked corrugated boards with increasingly smaller sizes, and the percent particles that end up in each layer, there's 10 of them, dictate a classification on that triangle chart you see there as to what that material is.
And sometimes when a SIV analysis is done, is it not correctly, they've got to remove X amount of yards?
Yes. This is a remove and replace. This is remove and replace. Yeah. But the state statute also says you have to design for the poorest of material. Even if you are going to do a remove and replace, which you have to do, especially when the material is this poor, you still have to design it in such a way that that material would support it. That's the state regulation on that.
Okay.
I'm going to make a motion on 41 Lorna Avenue to accept the variances as presented to the board as written.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, excuse me. I thought you were asking for a second, as opposed to second. Thank you.
Okay, 95 Washington Street. Oh, I'm sorry, 103.
I was going to say that.
103 Pleasant. My bad.
You said it.
Supersized prints.
For micro prints and supersized prints.
Oh my.
This is an existing
I can take my glasses off for this one.
Yes, you can take your glasses off for this one.
Are you good?
This is an existing four-bedroom split entry also being flipped. There are a significant amount of wetlands back. If Gary was sitting there, Gary would be sitting in the wetlands. So needless to say, pushing the septic to the front of house is desirable. However, that is also pushing it uphill. Obviously, wetlands would be in the lower area. That's why the pump chamber is required. And what they have asked for is a reduction from setback to seasonal high groundwater, seasonal high groundwater being the mark that is left staining the soil, indicating the highest level that the groundwater routinely sits at. They want to request a variance from 5 feet down to 4 feet, and under the grounds of maximum feasible compliance. This is already a pump system. They want to not, they're going to have to bring it up a little in the front yard. You can see here, this comes up about a foot-ish. By bringing it up 2 feet, obviously that's going to cost more in materials, and obviously it's going to severely affect the aesthetic of the front yard rather than being able to be blended in with natural grading.
How old is the pump system?
It will be brand new when installed.
So currently they don't...
Currently they have a non-functioning system at this time.
Okay.
There is a system in this place. We have no idea why we dug it up. It's clean. There is not a mark on it. The system that's in the backyard has visible surface outbreak. That's an automatic Title V failure criteria. I have a suspicion that while we had no documentation on it, at one point the backyard system, so to speak, the one that is actually breaking out in the backyard, when they went from some number of bedrooms up to four.
Stop.
Please.
Side two.
That at some point when they increased this home from some number of bedrooms, probably up to four, I'm going to guess that this raised ranch was not designed as a four-bedroom, that this system was some sort of add-on to complement those supplementary bedrooms. The reason I believe this is obviously look at the size. The size is less than half it would, what it would need to be. So my guess is there was some sort of original system. This was added as some sort of an add-on system. And I would never disparage, I have no idea who did the work, but because no water reached it, I mean, basically this was uphill of the tank and there was no pump in existence, water doesn't flow uphill.
Is there anything
so I think it overwhelmed.
File?
Yeah, there is, but they're long out of business. So it, whatever decision was made at that time, that front system never functioned and the back system was in very visible failure. And either way, Title V would indicate that the minute you've hit a failure criteria, you must redesign to accommodate the entire property. So that's what they did. They're flipping the home. They're putting it, it's on the market right now. And they have proposed doing this system out front and doing it properly. And the system designed and presented will accommodate the four-bedroom home without any issues at all. The only thing is they obviously, for aesthetic and monetary reasons, do not want to raise it up.
Too
also,
much.
This foundation, well, the foundation's only so high, too. And needless to say, you don't ever want to bring up dirt within a foot of a sill if you can possibly avoid it. That leads to rot and other undesirable aspects for the home. And that's the only variance they're requesting. It is a full-size system.
To the bottom of the leach field, less than 4 feet above the seasonal high groundwater.
As opposed to the five.
And how do they determine seasonal groundwater?
Modeling or redox morphic features are a basic stain line you will find on most materials, not all, that indicates that that's the level that high groundwater sits. Mr. Fine, you remember those,
that
right?
That a gray water level?
It's actually usually around Pembroke because of the iron in the water. It's an orange stain of some sort, most of the time. Not always.
Because there's a gray color line.
Gray is gradation where the water has sat there so much, it's actually pulled all the color out. So usually seasonal water is going to be above that gradation.
Mm-hmm. And I just ask these questions
for
you to clarify for everyone.
I love for everyone to know
4 feet or less than 4 feet?
It's going to be less than 4 feet because this is a class two material. The requirement would be four, so they're going to be just less than that.
Okay.
So class two material. Three and a half would be a very fair, but understand, I've made muddy of this, and I'm going to try and clear it up now. Depending on your class of material, we always talk about 5 foot to 4 foot groundwater separation. That's because 90% of Pembroke is class one material. It is sand. It's going to move very quickly. This is a class two material. Class two material will perk at a less than 15-minute and inch rate, so the actual setback would be 4 feet. I think what they have proposed, oh, he doesn't have a thumb note on here? He's too good an engineer for that. This guy was really good. I know he's got to have a thumb note for soils. No, he doesn't. What's that? He's a very sharp engineer. Out of town, but that doesn't mean anything. He's a very sharp engineer. And I don't see up there's a soil log.
It's the one right at the end of Pilgrim.
Correct.
What are you looking for?
I was just curious exactly what he called the separation the now.
Thumbnail. Is that on the...
Usually they put most engineers, when I say thumbnail, it's literally a micro picture. It's like a vertical snapshot of the soils. Most of them do that just to make it more user-friendly and accessible. This is the long form, soil suitability assessment form, which they are required to do by the state. Estimated depth to high groundwater is 76 inches. So the bottom, you would go back here on his elevation, 98. So there you go. So it's 3.5 feet.
Yeah.
This is something I would decide. This is good.
Well, I like the bigger.
Yeah.
It's way busy. It's very busy going on here.
Well, he's a different engineer.
Yep.
On 103 Pleasant Street to accept the single variance that was put before the board this evening.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So be it.
I mean, he put a tremendous amount of detail on it. Just to give you an idea, it came back with very few comments from David Primer, which is highly unusual. David Primer, four-star review engineer, who's on vacation. He's left us. I'm so sad.
Yeah, but he worked very hard before he left.
We have Paul Barogna. He's just on vacation. Paul Barogna is covering in his absence to take care of us until he returns. Paul Barogna is, of course, the owner and operator of Seacoast Engineering. Not already familiar. And moving right along, we're at 95 Washington. Yes. Okay. The board has already seen this, but there's a small revision made to it. For those of you that are not familiar, this is Alumni Cafe.
When did we see this?
You saw it a month ago, but they made some changes to try and save some money.
Literally Alumni Cafe?
Yeah, maybe 6 weeks ago. But you would have known 95 Washington unless I said it. You wouldn't know.
Yeah, I didn't put two and two together.
But anyway, some changes. Originally, the engineer had called for an additional aeration pump chamber. That was going to be extraordinarily costly, and it was not required by code, so it's being eliminated to try and save the client some money. No joke, the estimated cost on this septic system is somewhere around $100,000. This whole back parking lot's going to have to be torn out. Mm. The restaurant is going to have to close for a week to accommodate this work. The system is already in this location. We do not know exactly what happened, but the field has become completely saturated, which means one of two things. Either the original pump system, we suspect there might have been a maintenance issue, and that grease and other materials were getting out into the system that ought not have been getting out into the system. Either way, the system is completely saturated. A couple holes were punched in it. It's very highly impacted. Meaning the airspace that's supposed to be out there to absorb has been eliminated.
So they're going to dig it up.
Yep.
Bring in, rebuild in the same
dig it,
spot.
Not just dig it up. Dig out down to 5 feet. That is 5 feet of remove and replace.
Wow. And how many truckloads?
I would not even hazard a guess. A lot.
Wow.
A lot.
They have that much space in the back.
Wow.
Oh, yes. It's under their parking lot. Yes. It's not in the back. It's under the parking lot. Mm-hmm. That's why the cost starts to get staggering. Okay. They have to rip out the entire parking lot.
Because does any of this have to be redone?
Yes, it does. So one of the tanks is ruined too, and we're not entirely sure why. I think he's trying to salvage two of them. We're not positive if any of them are going to be able to be salvaged, but the attempt is going to be there to try and salvage. Oh, no, I take it out. He did call for a removal.
Removal of which tank? The existing tank.
Yep.
The grease trap.
It looks like the grease trap. He's the tie in the existing grease trap, so he managed to save that proposed. Okay, and then these are new. These are proposed pyramiding tanks to avoid, again, that secondary carryover. See, these are the only two tanks there now.
Mm-hmm.
These two here.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And we've talked in the past, you remember, obviously, settling tanks do a very important job. That job becomes 10 times more important in the situation of a restaurant. Now you see all these additional tanks.
So these are gonna go. These are gone.
Yes, it looks like he has called for both of them to be gone at this point.
Is this a funky, have you seen something?
Yes, this is very much in line with what they did for Mother Anna's, or I shouldn't say for Mother Anna's, but for that plaza. This is a very similar design to what was done there. That one also failed prematurely at only 15 years old.
So did you say they're getting rid of this one?
No, this is the revised plan. This is without the aerating chamber. That pump chamber is going to be there.
Okay.
The other chamber and technology was what was going to cost an additional $40,000, which the owner obviously did not have the stomach for. And if please feel free to talk to him or the engineer. This is just what they told me why they wanted to adopt the new plan. This plan is compliant. It has been reviewed. Obviously, aeration and additional treatment would only help the longevity of the system, but cost is a factor.
What are they going to do with Lisa? You
know? My understanding is Mr. Gibbons said he was going to close the week of July 4th to do this.
He wants to do it quick.
Yes.
Like next week.
Yes.
Gotcha. Okay.
I think that was his plan. And please, that was what he said to me. I mean, plans can change. I can't hold him to that when he installs it, but that's what he had said to me verbally.
Okay. Any further discussion? I'd like to make a motion to accept the variances as written. All in favor?
Aye.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
He used some colorful language I won't repeat.
Well,
it's a heck of a check to write out.
Yeah, especially to be buried in the ground.
Yep. So, and we do have copies of the old plan as well, just as a comparison.
We are. The next step is contract vote for. Gary Fine. I apologize to everyone. Want to apologize for my outburst earlier. To those here and to those who are watching at home. I do not like to get myself in that type of a position. Gary, can you give us an update on where we stand with our complaint?
Sure. I spoke to the attorney, Carolyn, Murray, thank you. I had a conversation with her today is Monday. I think I spoke with her Thursday evening, could have been Wednesday evening. Both complaints have been officially, the attorney's response to both complaints have been submitted. She has not heard back from her contact at the Attorney General's office. I did ask her what was, typical, and every situation is different, but in a complaint such as these, not that every complaint is going to be identical, what might her expectation be to hear? And she said something in the line of 30 days when we would hear something. She told me, I don't need to call her as soon as she hears as soon as she gets a response. She will let me know. She felt fairly. I don't want to speak for her, but she thinks that we will hear within 30 days.
Wonderful.
That was but she didn't know how the Attorney General would rule, but so not much of a status, not much of an update.
Okay, and when those when that official report comes down for the Attorney General, I am assuming that
both myself and Gail McSweeney will get a copy of the finding?
Yes, everyone.
Everybody involved will have an official.
Yep, okay. Everybody.
Is it possible for us, both myself and Gail, to get a copy of the response that Carolyn Murray submitted on behalf?
Yes.
I'd like to request that both of us get a copy of that.
Okay.
You could ask her to send it to our emails.
Yep.
I think that it would be perfect or good for our records.
Yep. Speaking of which, so is there on both of your emails, I know I've received emails from you, got, so neither one of you is still on the towns?
I'm not going on the towns.
Okay.
And mine is still being worked on,
gotcha.
So you
okay.
can still use mine.
I'm under McSweeney.org.
And you included it.
So it's a different identity than my regular email. It's just for the Board of Health.
Okay. I will reach out to her and I'll find out what's the best, you know, if she'll email it to you guys.
Okay. Or she can mail it.
Okay.
Whatever works with her. Okay, so that's good.
Yes.
Okay,
yep.
Perfect. Next one came up last week in regards to the health agent's contract vote. We were asked to vote on renewing her contract. That brought up a discussion. The question I said I would do was to go back to Ed Thorne's office, because it is a contract, and the Board of Selectmen, because they are wage and personnel. They're the ones who write and have the final approval on the contract. There is no section under the time frame. I actually sent along what you had given me, Gail, at the end of last meeting or the beginning of the last meeting, section 21. I don't know if you gave me the wrong law, but it has something to do with town meeting.
Nope, that's the right one. That's how the board is to be taken over, or how we are to release any authority from the board members.
Okay, well, the back to the
that's
email.
That's the general law.
Yeah, well, the general law that's being quoted by the town accountant and the people who run the town, not town accountant, but the town administrator and the selectman's office are stating that is actually section 108N, section 108N, which I sent along to everybody, as well as section 108O and section 30. So there is a discrepancy in regards to what section...
Chapter 41,
section 21. Section 21, yeah. Chapter 41, section 21 has to do with the health board's contract versus chapter 41, section 108N and... I think it's 1080, or it looks like that could be an O, 41, both under chapter 41. So what we're being advised is that you ask the laws pertaining to the time frame allowed by the law to take a vote on renewing the health agent's contract. Under Mass General Law 41, there are provisions for contracts between the town and the following positions: town manager, town administrator, executive secretary, administrative assistant to the BOS, that would be Board of Selectmen, town accountant, city auditor, city manager, police chief, fire chief. Under this language, section 108N, as in Nancy, states that the town may establish a contract for a period of town. This section does not, under what time frame, doesn't address under what time frame the contract may be renewed, nor does it state under what time frame the contract may not be renewed. So you all have a copy of these three laws. So mm-hmm. I have to say that I guess I would have to agree with the town administrator because he should know the law. But with that being said, we were asked to look at Lisa Cullity's contract ahead of March 22nd, March 17th. So when I go back and I listen to the minutes of the meeting, which are provided by tape as well as on camera, it's actually stated that typically we look at these as of the first of the year. So with that being said, there is no law that says we have to wait a certain amount of time.
Correct.
Okay, so I think we should stay at this point in time, my opinion, and I'd like to make a motion that we hold off until I'd like to address it before the end of the year. Our last Board of Health meeting for 2016, Carol, in December, to actually vote on the renewal. And I don't know if we even have the dates out to that, Carol, but if you can leave it. But I'd like to do the very last Monday Board of Health meeting in 2016, whatever night that falls on. And I'd like to have the board vote on the contract at this point in time.
Madam Chair, can I ask for
day after Christmas? No, I won't.
No.
Yeah, so, yeah, because we won't be meeting the day after Christmas. So we'll do it as of the 19th of December, if we can put that on the agenda.
Can I request, Madam Chair, that we receive, that we're able to review the contract?
You have it.
As a board?
You have it.
I have the contract. Mm-hmm. I have a contract from 2014.
It's the same contract. It's still in effect until March of 2017.
Okay, but the it'll updates be the same as far as the pay is updates that need to be made to this to bring us up to
I don't time. Believe on that contract there has anything to do about her pay.
Pay is not included in the contract. Correct. It is settled by town meeting in the Wage and Personnel Board advised town meeting.
Yeah, town meeting, you already
I'm
voted on her.
The SA schedule, so this board has no control over my compensation.
Exactly.
Town meeting has control over my compensation.
So it's a standard, it's the exact same contract?
It's just the terms of employment, that's all it is.
Right.
All it says is you have a job or you don't have a job.
Right. And you brought that up at the last meeting, and yes, it's not. It's the same contract that's in force right now. There won't be any changes
to it. I will review it, and if there's any updates, I will highlight them.
And this is the first time I'm going to do this and probably the last, but I'm bringing it back to when we used to do this and sign the contract. The health agent's pay rate was in there, the workman's comp, everything was tied together.
When was this, when you were clerical or when you were?
When I was clerical. Mr. McGinnis, actually the Board of Health chair at the time, submitted the contract to be signed for Mr.
And I believe when Mr. McGinnis gave over control, correct
actually,
me if
that's
I'm wrong.
Incorrect.
Okay.
I was the one that established a contract for Mr. Leary. It was always terms of employment. Mr. Leary's compensation was always under the SA 27 classification of the wage and personnel bylaw.
Lisa, I'm going to have to correct you on that because Mr. Leary didn't have a contract for 4 years solid.
Correct, and I'm the one that created it.
Mr. McGinnis.
I went to town meeting. I'm the one that argued for his raises.
Mr. McGinnis.
Okay, I guess you're going to have to find it. I didn't see it. I created a contract for him. I was the one that advocated for his raise on town meeting floor.
I made a motion.
He was without a contract
for
4 years prior to the 2008 when he received the contract.
Then by all means, if he has it and you can show the document was created.
I most definitely can.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So there's a motion on the table made by Madam Chair.
I have a question. So is there a dispute that this contract is inaccurate?
I need to see what's in it.
I have a copy of the contract. That's a contract in force.
It was given out last meeting.
It doesn't resemble any form of contract that we've ever done in the past.
So would you like to recreate a new contract?
I would like to review.
No, but I'm asking what information, what is in
I would like to review at this point.
Sure, but what information would you like? I'm at a loss as to how to produce
if
something.
If I need to ask for information, Lisa, I'll contact you. I'll request it then.
Okay, yeah, I have a motion. Okay.
So there's a motion on the table by Madam Chair. You set a date which late in December. So doing the math, which I'm pretty good at, what I'm here, and I'm looking for clarification to your motion. You're kind of talking about maybe looking at the contract or you table it to roughly 90 days, you know, so the end of December, 90 days if the contract is March 27th. Mm-hmm. Okay, so mm-hmm. I would like to make an amendment to your motion that you made. If I hope I'm phrasing it properly. I'd like to just change your motion from, I'd like to change the date in your motion from a date, the last date in December. I'd like to move it to a date in November and make it a 120-day. So rather than just, I'm trying to make an amendment to the motion rather than the last Board of Health meeting in December, which effectively would give us a 90-day window. I think I'd like to vote on the health agent's contract 120 days. That feels more adequate to me.
Okay, so the motion now is on the table to make it, instead of the mid-December, to make it 120, which will pull us into November. Do I hear a second on that?
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And please, if you have any questions, please ask Lisa.
Carol, can you provide the board with, because we just accepted the motion on 120 days, so what would be, you don't have to tell me this instant, but the nearest?
Well, if her date is the 14th, I have a Monday on the 14th of November.
14th November? Thank you.
Okay, mandatory ethics training. Gail, have you taken the ethics training yet?
Nope, I have not.
Okay. Remember you had 2 weeks?
Two different things, Madam Chairman. Open meeting law is the 2 weeks. Ethics just came out. I believe we all have 45 days or something to complete it.
Okay.
Open meeting law is within 2 weeks of election, sitting on a board.
Open meeting law has been taken care of with the town clerk.
Perfect.
And
we're all doing ethics training.
Ethics,
we all have a copy of it right now to sign and return.
Is it in my purple packet?
It's in my blue packet, so.
Okay.
Assuming all these packets are equal, it should be in. Sorry, I cannot answer what the clerk said to me exactly when it came in. I forget the exact time frame, and I wish she had put it on here, but unfortunately.
Here it is. Almost to the end.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
Except it says May 10th of 2013 on mine, so I'm confident that is inaccurate. Oh no, that's a revision. It must be received by and revised. Where's the date for receiving? I'm sorry, I do not
see
the date.
Okay, so you want us to date today?
No, I have no idea, but why,
Donna?
It doesn't say when it's supposed to be back.
Do you want us to date this copy today, sign that we received the
permit,
date it today?
Yes.
And then we'll be on the
We have to give them.
Completing this within.
Correct. And we have to, these will all be sent over to Mary Ann.
It doesn't say on here. I can't.
It doesn't say. That's what I'm.
The last acknowledgement is just of receipt, not of
location. Right. I'm surprised we don't have a deadline.
I'm surprised as well.
We're both surprised.
I'm sure there's somewhere out there.
What?
Madam Chair.
Thank you.
It just says make sure the copy gets back to the.
Just the name.
27.
Lisa, we all filled out the first page.
Oh, mine says receipt on the last page. Well, I can fill out the first page too. I'm happy to do it.
Yeah, but my question then falls is the Does the email?
I would believe the acknowledgement I've seen in the email.
Yeah, but.
I mean, there's two different.
It doesn't say, I just want to make sure that the website link is within the body.
Right, I was going to say.
Of this, because it's on this, right.
It's on the front page of where you go to take it.
So this one's the 2013, so that's invalid anyways.
Unless they haven't revised it. If they haven't revised it,
yeah, I don't think it's been revised since.
And I wonder.
I think ethics is ethics.
I wonder if it was going to be revised, if it has anything to do with the attorney that was here.
No,
I don't know if there's
No, it doesn't. This was sent to Marianne, according to this, it was sent to Marianne December 15th.
Okay.
So, December 2015, pardon me. 10th.
All right, because.
So this is the most recent version because it was sent by the state in this version, so.
All right, well, we all kind of looked at this the same way with the exception of Lisa. I'm going to give this page back to everyone. The reason being is there's the login website.
Okay.
So if we can now sign the last page. And pass that in, and keep your first. Last revision date on this document was. Thank you. And then, okay. Lisa, we have yours, so we all have homework to do. If we could get it done sooner rather than later, then we don't have to think about it. Reason I threw the summer schedule on is July 11th. Lisa Cullity will not be here. I have just been scheduled for a procedure that I have to prep for on Monday, the 11th, for a Tuesday procedure.
Oh, those are lovely.
So,
enjoy yourself.
Thank you. Being as honest a person as I am, I don't mind sharing that. Everyone should, by the way. I'm not going to be here.
Okay.
So, you have, the two of you can meet?
I would say maybe
or
next
we
meeting
can
be placed off to the July 25th.
Yep. So that's, I'm just advising you that I'm not going to be here on July 11th.
Are you out that week?
Yep. Yes.
Are you out that week? Are you?
She's out that day.
I'm out that day. So really Monday and Tuesday.
Well, that's our next meeting.
Yes, yeah, that's okay. Our next meeting.
So I'd like to make a motion that we our next meeting be July 25th.
Do I hear a second?
I'll second that motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
Just the emergency in between.
Yes.
Someone can try to make, I would be loath to do the 4th, but the 5th or the 18th, possibly if we have an emergency item that we need to get together for.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We don't.
Unless there's anything else, I'd like to adjourn this meeting at 7:49. Do I hear a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Good night.